Hey guys, how's it going? This is Mr. Hell, Digital Media Class. For this particular session, I want to start from scratch. This is for anybody who is interested in learning about video editing or who have a little bit of experience but wants to learn all the basic fundamentals of what you need to learn in order to be proficient in video editing. Like I said, I am a digital media teacher at a high school, and have certifications in Premiere Pro and Photoshop. And so as you continue to stay on this path, there are some great things that you can be able to learn and achieve in this digital age that we're living in today. All right, so like I said, we're going to start from scratch. I already created a project called New Video, but basically, like I said, this is what you're seeing right now. This is when you first launched Premiere Pro. This is 2019. So when you first launched Premiere Pro, the first thing actually that you want to do, like I said, I click New Video. You see the name right there. The first thing you need to do is always name your project. That's how you're able to find what you need and keep things pretty much organized. All right, so for this video, just New Video Project, all right? I name it New Video Project. That's the name of my project that we're gonna work on in class, right? I'm just gonna give a couple of seconds to load. All right, so I remember when I first got on Premiere, I was pretty proficient in different editing softwares. Like Filmora and Sony Vegas, and there's a whole bunch of different things out there. But I remember when I first looked at Premiere Pro, I was like, what am I looking at? And it can look intimidating at first, but like I said, I'm going to break down these different things. But before we get started, I just want you guys to know that like where I have my mouse hovering around, all of this is called the interface. And basically what the interface is what you're looking at, all right? This is the program itself. This is like from scratch. And so this is always a good place to start. And like I said, I'm gonna, throughout the video, I would import some clips in there for you guys so you can see exactly what you're looking at. But to start off, like I said, this is what you're looking at. This top left panel is called the source monitor. This is where you can pre-look at your clips before you actually put them for editing, all right? This is called the program monitor. Program is basically, it shows your editing, it shows your video as you're editing, all right? Bottom. And the bottom panel is called timeline, and that's where you're gonna do a lot of your work at. This is pretty much your workspace right there. In the bottom left corner is basically where you import your footage, your music, and so on. All right. So these are different clips that I have that I'm going to import. Let's see what happens. Oh, I got one, two. Alright. So pretty much basically what I did was took files that was already on my computer and put them in what you call the project folder. In this folder, you can be able to see your clips. You see if I hover my mouse around it, I can kind of see exactly what the clip is and what it looks like. And the correct term for that is actually called scrubbing, all right? And that is a vocab word that I want you guys to remember. And so, like I said, these are three video clips. I'm going to drag this up here, which is the source monitor, like as we talked about earlier. And so this is where I'm able to look at my video before I actually am serious about it, right? Let's see if I can move this. So I'm just looking to see, you know, what did I actually like from the video, right? So, say for instance, I like this shot right here. Boom. All right, so I can take out certain parts of the clip before using the whole clip. So I'm looking at this clip right here. Now what I just did right here, this is a marking endpoint, and it's pretty much starting that video at that point. So I got that, keep moving on, and this is a marking out point. And so like I said, even before you begin, start editing, these are different things that you can look at. Far as what do you want to do before you start editing? I already trimmed the clip before I started editing it. And then it gives me an option, do I want to drag the video only or do I want to drag the audio only? For this purpose, I'm just going to drag the video into the timeline panel, all right? This timeline panel is basically where I'm going to do my editing at, all right? So you see this clip, this bar right here, this is pretty much the clip right there. And then you saw when I put this clip in there, this showed up, all right? And this is pretty much showing you what you're doing in editing, all right? So we're not working on the source right now. We already took what we wanted out. If you can see it right here, it's already highlighted. And so this is pretty much the clip right there. And so this is just an overall view of what you're looking at. And I didn't understand it at first, you know, but now it's like, hey, this is easy. I get it now. So even before I start editing my clips, I can trim my clips and get it more specific before I start editing. All right. Some other things you can start seeing about in Premiere is like you have all these tools here. It's a whole bunch of different buttons and different things that, you know, that you'll be able to learn as we go, all right? Some of the most important tools that we use is called the Razor tool. And that's the first tool I'm gonna actually go over, all right? Razor tool is pretty much self-explanatory. So if I'm, like I said, editing a video, I wanted it to stop at 2 minutes. I'm going into that 2 minutes. Go to that 2 minute. That tool is already showing on my thing right now, on my timeline. Click on that. And as you can see here, I have two separate clips, all right? And so with those two separate clips, you can choose to do what you want to do with them. But these are the basic tools that I want you guys to start seeing, all right? See, and then I already have it labeled. You got the pen tool, hand tool, you got a text tool or type, ripple, and track selection for it, all right? All right, so you got assembly is a tab. And basically what assembly does, it makes sure your project panel almost like almost a third of your screen. And so from that, you can actually put your clips in order based off of how you want things to look. So if I wanted to start off my video with this clip right here, I can drag this and switch this over. This is going to be my first scene, all right? Like I said, when you learn more about the phases of production, this is a big phase. This is pretty much like pre-production stuff, all right? When it comes to storyboards, this is a visual storyboard right there to show you the scene selections of how you want things to be placed in order, all right? So I'm gonna start off with this clip right here. Second clip, I'm gonna keep the basketball goal right there. I'm gonna make it seem like, you know, he made a shot. Third scene is this. And so Now I already have my things in order how I want things to look. All right. So like I said, if I actually like this clip, I can just click and drag into this. All right. Now, what you first start off by seeing when I was in the assembly, when I dragged that clip, you also see this green bar at the bottom, right? And basically what that green bar is showing is audio. And so if I click play.
Dog, we're staying in the same place though. That's perfect right there.
So basically what I'm doing is directing, showing, showing a good friend of mine what I'm looking for him to do, and so I can get the right shot for him. All right, and so if you can see where my mouse is hovering over, I have V1. V stands for video and A stands for audio. All right, and so as you can see here, I have one video track and one audio track. These things are linked together. Now a quick hack that I can show you how to separate them. You can right click. You'll learn a lot of things by right clicking on something. There's a whole bunch of different things you can do in there. You can change the speed, duration. You can increase the audio levels. You can also unlink it, which I was originally trying to show you what to do. And so now these things are separate. So they're not together anymore. I can actually delete that if I wanted to. All right. And now I'm only stuck with video. Now, as you can tell, you know, I shot this footage, but it have some parts in there that's kind of blurry. But I think I want to start my clip off at 5 seconds. All right, we're gonna start off at 5 seconds. Well, I'm not gonna be as perfect, but so. Some quick things, like I said, remember I said the razor tool, you can click on that. Now these things are separate. I can click backspace and that's pretty much gone. Now, as you should know, if you make a mistake, like I said, it's not the end of the world. You can always click Control Z and you always get it back, right? But another thing that you'll always learn about when you deal with software, there's always more than one way to do the same thing, all right? And so one of the easiest ways, even besides using the tool, you just go to the end of the video track. So you see how the mouse changes to red? It's grabbing the end of that video clip and I can actually drag it and it cut it the same way. Or just like how we were when we first started. Remember, I already cut out a certain section already. You can cut out your video and your source monitor as well. So it's really about your editing flow and what works better for you. All right. So like I said, I'm gonna start off in 5 seconds. I'm gonna drag this over. And so here he is. He's, you know, in his zone, dribbling the ball. Boom, I'm in that there. I'll also see if there's anything else that I want out of that. So what I did with the camera, I started moving around them, started panning a little bit. So I like the shot right there. All right. Like I said, I go to the end of that clip, drag it. Click on the middle part, backspace, and that's the second clip. Boom.